Hey guys, what is up? It is July 7th. I haven't done any vlogging for July and I wasn't even gonna vlog today. And then I said, you know what? Let me just go ahead and tell them what's going on. Anyway, a lot has gone on July. We have done the fireworks for July 4th. I had my friend and my godson come in town and stay with us. Didn't get any of that. They went fishing, didn't get any of that. AJ had all his people over another day and we cooked out for his friends. Didn't get any of that. So July has been a busy month already and didn't get any of it. And I wasn't going to get today, but I said, well, let me just go ahead and get on before I fool around and let July go without talking to you guys at all. So just left. We're having our family reunion this coming weekend. So I just left the place that I'm going to have it. And they told me that they're no longer going to be renting it out. We were the last people because, so we'll get to use it on Saturday. And then after that, they're not renting it out anymore because people have been abusing the privileges and not cleaning up the place, letting their kids tear up the walls. They're finding fecal matter in the trash cans and all kind of stuff. It's like, really, why do you have to be so trifling and mess it up for everybody else? So that's what she said. She said, yep, she said, those people have messed it up for everybody, and it was so reasonable, and we got the inside and the outside, and I'm just like, you have got to be kidding. So, with all that said, I'm kind of bummed about that because it was close to my home, and it just met all of our needs. So, we've used that place multiple times, and we've always cleaned up, never had an issue, and now all of a sudden, somebody's coming in messing it up for us. So, now, I don't know what we're going to do from here on out. But anyway, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. And so then I went to the post office and I was supposed to go to the bank, but I forgot to go to the bank and now I'm running flight going. So I'm getting ready to head back to the house because it is kind of later in the day and I need to decide on what I'm going to do for dinner. I did want to let you know, I got on my Marion hat for AJ school, but I did want to let you know that I got a new video coming. If you see, my hair is in braids. Can you believe it? Y'all know I don't do braid outs. But I decided to do a braid out on stretched hair because I stretched my hair. And I got a new video coming because I stretched it with the Rev Air. So you guys will see that. I'll wait and tell you what I think about it in that video. So y'all make sure that y'all watch that video. It'll probably be up. I know it'll be up before, it's already up. So go ahead and just look at it. It's definitely up before this video, this vlog. So go ahead and take a look at that. But yeah, I stretched my hair. So I said, you know what? I might as well let them see that. These are my bangs. And let y'all know that is coming. I don't know why I'm gonna put this back on. I'm going in the house. But yeah, just wanted to come on and say, hey, July started getting away from me and I was like, they don't look up and I won't have anything for July. So hopefully this vlog, July vlog, will be shorter than the other ones. I am gonna try to cut them down. I know some of you have been saying you're liking the longer vlogs, which is great, but I'm gonna tell you something. It makes it easier for me when I'm vlogging so I know I don't have to kind of feel rushed to get a vlog out. I know that as long as I get it out by the end of the month, that's great. So it helps me that way, but it doesn't help me when I'm ready to edit because those long vlogs, if you're getting an hour vlog, you know that vlog is longer than an hour. So I've cut it down and chopped out a lot of stuff to get it to an hour. So I don't know. So I'm going to try to keep it down to... For a long vlog, maybe 40 minutes. I'm gonna try to keep it shorter than that. It's just gonna depend. I'm still kind of just winging it, weighing it out. I think I dropped that paper down there. I'll get it. So anyway, guys, wanna let you know that my cousin's trying to call me, so let me get her and I'll talk to you guys later. want to go over there where the umbrella's up? Thank you.
She's like, oh, okay, yeah, he talks real well. Respectful and everything.
Not respectful, like, all right, how you doing?
So we've been to Mexican, had Mexican at a restaurant we've never been to before downtown. Now we are getting ready to get some ice cream downtown. And Avery and AJ are going to play ping pong. Here's the other ping pong table. Ping pong table. They got foosball too. So we're going to go to this Howdy. Now open. Howdy's homemade ice cream. Got a bowl of water out here. Let's have some dogs. Hi, how are you? Guys, this hair is fluffing up more and more. Am I zoomed in? I guess not. They're talking trash again with each other. They're gonna need to hurry up because I'm ready to go. It's like, why y'all always finding stuff to do with two people and it's three of us? Anyway. So Avery got him ice cream. AJ and I, we didn't want ice cream because we just ate and we're stuffed, and I have to have a taste for ice cream. I'm not like an ice cream person, but I need to get home because I got stuff I wanted to do today, and they out here hanging around. But as y'all can see in the background, it's somewhat gloomy, small breeze, but it's still warm. Humid out, so my hair is kind of swelling up a little bit, but all in all, it's actually doing better than I thought it was going to do out here. So yeah, if you're wondering, this is a braid out on stretched hair. I use the Revair to stretch my hair, and then I braided it with the Baskin Bloom Mango Twisting Cream, I think is what it's called. I braided it with that and then took it out today. And this is what I got. So yeah, guys, anyway, let me finish keeping up with them. I'll talk to y'all later. They changed sides. I guess they thought if they changed sides they would do better. Neither one of them has played, so Avery's trying to beat him, but it ain't working. Okay guys, so we made it back home and I'm in my filming room, so I just finished filming this hair to show how it held up. And yeah, looked outside, and of course all my son's friends are over playing basketball, so you may hear it, the ball bouncing, and there's Cotton. So I may go out there and give you guys a look. But yeah, we enjoyed our time out in the humidity, and I think I'm going to go ahead and just get myself ready for basically to hunker down for the evening. I think I'm gonna pineapple my hair tonight and then decide what other styles I want to do with it, since it has been stretched a little bit. So yeah, I'll just wear it pinned up maybe tomorrow until I think about what it is that I want to do. But in the meantime, I'm gonna eating your leftovers. Heating up his Mexican leftovers. I'll let y'all see what's going on out here. Can y'all see him? They ain't got no shirts on or nothing out here. Try. Gotta be quiet. Trying not to get them too much on video since they ain't got no shirts on. Don't want to do all that, but that was what? I think you saw three or four people. There were some more in the garage, but I didn't want to be too obvious with my camera. They didn't ask to be put on. But anyway, that's what goes on at my house for the most part. And yeah, go ahead and take care of this. And I actually, I'm not hungry yet, but I am going to have to eat before 8. I'm trying to, y'all know I'm trying to do my, watch my weight. So I'm trying to not eat after 8 o'clock. Like I said, it's 7. So, well, I don't know if I said that or not, but it's 10 after 7. So, I'm gonna give myself a little bit longer and then I'm gonna try to eat something so I can get through the evening. But yeah, guys, that's it for today. I'll catch up with y'all later. Okay, guys, I don't know where I left off with this vlog, but I am going now to do a few errands. Avery is at home working in the office. He's on the conference call, so I'm trying to get a few things done. We're supposed to go out together today. Getting chilly. We're supposed to go out together today and do some stuff, but he's on the conference call, so I'm going to go ahead and get some stuff done that I can do. Well, I can do all of it on my own, but he just wants to go. So I'm going to do what I can that he doesn't necessarily need to go with me to do. So our family reunion is this weekend. I think I told you guys that. So I am going to pick up the key to the venue because they said I could pick it up either today or tomorrow. I'm going to probably be busy tomorrow prepping for Saturday. So I want to go ahead and get it out of the way today. So I'm going to go pick up the key for the venue. And then I'm going to go to Dollar Tree and get some things that I need from Dollar Tree. I also have to go check my P.O. box, so I'm going to do that. So little things like that that I'm going to go ahead and do that's around the area. So he doesn't have to worry about doing that with me. And where is all of this traffic coming from in the middle of the day? These people should be at work. Anyway, so yeah, I'm going to do that. So, yeah, just wanted to get on and tell you guys that. And then my hair, guys. Oh, my goodness. So, I can't see, but I'm going. Y'all can sit there if y'all want to. There's traffic. My hair, guys, is a wash and go using one of my favorite combos. Okay? Believe it or not, it was one of my favorite combos. And it's like, Did it feel me? Because I haven't done the combo for a little bit. And when I was doing my hair, I felt like I used more product than I normally do. I don't know why I felt that way. I kind of just felt that way. Then it took longer to dry than it normally does. And I'm like, man, it don't normally take this long to dry. And then I wanted to use the Revair to stretch it. So I had done, you know, a video on the Revair. And then I started hearing that people were using it to stretch their wash and goes instead of using the blow dryer. So let me try that. So I tried it and it did stretch it, but it stretched it kind of ill-shapen. So I think I have more control over how my hair is shaped with the handheld dryer, but I don't know. I've been doing that longer, so maybe I just have to get used to what to do with the Revair. So anyway, it stretched it, but for some reason my hair feels so freaking soft, and soft to the point where, you know how you use a product that's high in glycerin and your hair feels kind of soft and a tad bit sticky? That what It's not feeling that sticky now. That's how my hair was feeling all day yesterday and today. When I woke up, and so once I took off my scarf and showered and just kind of let the hair hit, the air hit it a little bit, it doesn't feel, it still feels very soft, but it doesn't feel as sticky or whatever today. So that let me know that I think I did use too much product, and then I need to go back and see when I normally use this combo, because it has been humid here. It's been rainy. It's even gloomy today. I don't know if you guys could tell or not, but it's been rainy and a little humid. So I don't know if that has something to do with how it performed this time or not. But I'm like, what? So with that being said, my hair looks like this because I didn't do anything to it today. I didn't stretch it or anything because I want it to last. I don't want to have to redo my hair before our family reunion. So I don't want to stretch it too much and then it get too frizzy or whatever. So I'm just kind of letting it be today, since I don't have to do anything but run a few errands. And then tomorrow I'm going to try to just let it be. And then I'll try to stretch it and make it bigger and really pretty for Saturday. That is my plan. Now, will that work out? I don't know. But I know y'all probably thinking, what is wrong with her hair? It's flatter than usual and it just kind of doesn't look the same. But anyway, that's what's going on with that. So let me go here and take care of picking up this key real quick, and I'll be back. Whew, okay, so got that done. They gave me a key card. I'm going to put that in my purse. Don't lose it, Rachel. Don't forget where you put it. And anyway, you just kind of tap the key card, and it opens up the door, and I'm thinking, if something happens and this key card don't work, so I said, what if we get here on Saturday and the key card doesn't work? What do I do? And she said, it'll work. And I'm looking at her, I'm like, okay. But what if it doesn't? What do we do? Because I'm that type of person. It's like, you know what? Anything can go wrong, and you need to think ahead and you need to plan for the worst. Prepare for the, what does it say? What's that saying? Plan for the best and prepare for the worst, or whatever. You know what I'm saying. So she said, it'll work, but let me give you my card. And I said, okay. I said, because I didn't know if I called somebody, if there was a code that they would have me push in or whatever to get in. And she was like, no, even though there's numbers on there. So I bet there is. I wasn't going to ask her for it, but I bet if I call her, she's going to have some type of code to get me in, hopefully. But she said, so here's my number, but it's going to work, so don't panic. And I'm like, okay. So I took her number. Now, if it don't work and there's nothing she can do to get us in, we're going to just have to, I guess, stay on the outside. But I'm concerned about the food. That's what we have to get onto the inside, is the food, so it's not out in the sun. Worst come to worst, I guess we can take all the food at my house, and then we can have it at my house because I'm not too far from here, and we can just be in the backyard. However, by me not being able to get in, if I have a card and I can call right away to let them know, then I can get my money back. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to wait until Monday and then say, oh, by the way, we couldn't get in and I want my money back. And then they're like, well, why didn't you call me on the day of? Did y'all still use the facility? You know, that type of thing. So I just covered my butt. But anyway, so I picked that up. Now I'm getting ready to go. I have to go to the bank too. I'm gonna go to the Dollar Tree. Well, I'm gonna go to the bank first. Go ahead and deposit the check that I got from Rakuten. I keep telling y'all about Rakuten, guys. If you are not using Rakuten, if you shop online, if you shop in store and you're buying things that you're gonna actually buy anyway, and you're not using the Rakuten app where you get cash back, I don't know what you're doing. And if you have a credit card that you use where you get cash back, then that's double cash back. You get paid cash back from Rakuten, you get cash back from your credit card. I mean, come on. So, anyway, I opt to have the check sent to me versus, going straight into my account and all that kind of stuff, because that just cuts down on me having to give people my bank account number, routing number, and all that stuff. You know what I'm saying? So, anyway, So that's why I haven't opted to come to me, but you guys don't have to do that. You probably could get it going to your bank account, or I think you may be able to get it to go to PayPal or whatever. I don't know. It's been so long since I've had Rakuten and set this up that I don't even know what they offer anymore. But anyway, so I'm going to go deposit that check, because I get a check from them quarterly, and that check be coming in handy. So anyway, so I'm going to deposit that check, and then I'm going to go to the dollar store. I really need to concentrate in the dollar stores. I don't know if I'll get any footage of that or not. I might. Depends on what I'm picking up. I'm not getting a lot. It's very boring what I'm getting. But if I don't get that stuff when I head back to get Avery, because we're supposed to go to BJ's and all that, then maybe I'll get some footage of us doing that. Alrighty. Anyway, let me get to this bank. Good. Can you just deposit into the checking account on the back?
I can.
Thank you. All right. Get this done, guys. Let me go here in my conversation. So Saturday would be fourth day hair. So today is actually second day hair that I didn't do anything to. Tomorrow's going to be third day. I'm not going to do a whole lot to it unless... Oh, yes, I am. I am going to have to stretch it tomorrow, because tomorrow we're going to an outside concert, outdoor concert. So I do want to look okay for that. And then Saturday will be fourth day hair. So hopefully it'll hold up. I can't hear you. Oh. Duh. You talking to the people that drove up over there? I didn't even see that little car over there. I just saw her, moving her mouth, and I'm thinking, what is she moving her mouth for? Anyway, back to what I was saying, I am going to have to stretch it tomorrow, so I hope it looks halfway decent for Saturday. We're going to see.
Sorry about that, I got to go take care of you.
That's okay, thank you. Got that. So yeah, so hopefully it'll look okay. And if not, I'm gonna try to stretch it in the morning before the concert to see how it looks, because if my hair looks a hot mess, I might have to wash it tomorrow before the concert and before Saturday, our family reunion, because I don't want my hair looking a hot mess. You need to get in the rain. What is wrong with people? I don't want my hair looking a hot mess, but we'll see. I'm just hoping and praying that it'll all come together. But yeah, I got to figure out what I did wrong. Why was I so heavy-handed? Or is it because of the weather that my favorite combo ain't trying to... It ain't my favorite. It's one of my favorites, but why it ain't trying to do what it's supposed to do and give me the look that I was going for. So, anyway, let me go into this Dollar Tree and I'll catch up with you guys later. Okay. So I'm in here, and of course I'm filming on my phone, so I can't really prop you guys up the way that I want to. So for me to do what I need to do, I can't be holding my phone like this in my hand. So I'll get with you guys when I get back in the car. Guys, why me? So I put y'all away when I got into Dollar Tree because I said I couldn't look around, which was true, but also they were playing music in there, so I didn't want to get any copyright strikes. So I just got to shopping, going up and down each and every aisle, which I hardly ever do in Dollar Tree. I think I used to back in the day, but then I quit doing it. I'd usually just go in there for my movie candy, and every once in a while go in there, see what kind of hair products they got, or just pick up one odd and in, right? So I'm going up and down every aisle because I'm not in a hurry. Because I was waiting for Avery and he did call me, so that's why I rushed out of there. But guys, I started putting all kind of stuff in my cart that I didn't need. This is why I don't like to go vlogging in stores and Target and Dollar Tree and Meijer, wherever you go and you vlog, you are going to see something and put it in your basket. And I did. And a lot of the things I can use and I'm going to use, but it's frivolous stuff. Had I not went in there, I wouldn't have got. So, for instance, candy. I always stock up on movie candy because we watch movies at the house. We go to the movies and the candy there is cheaper than at the movies. So I stocked up on some of that. I went in there for pans for Saturday, the big long baking pans for food to heat up under the thing. I went in there to get some of those, and I got those. But then I also got some toothpaste, which was Crest and Colgate. I'm gonna try the Crest 3D White that I had talked about. They had that in there for $1.25. Okay, that stuff costs almost, if it's the one, I think it's the same one. I have to look at it, but it costs more than $1.25 at the store, okay? And then they had the Colgate Optic White or something like that. I saw it. I haven't tried Colgate in forever, and I said, let me pick this up and try it. Maybe AJ will like it. Maybe Avery will like it or whatever, and we can get away from some of the more expensive toothpastes. Turn the corner. Okay, so now I've got rebel rage because I'm trying to hurry up and get home because my husband had called me. So I got that. Then I got some olives because they were cheap and I love olives. So I got some olives out of there that I don't normally get. And I was supposed to get a card. I never did make it back to the cards because he called. But we're having the family reunion this weekend, and I actually got some games or some little toys for the kids for the family reunion. They were only $1 something. So just to have something for them to play with. I think somebody else brought some games as well. I don't know what, but these are individual. So if a kid don't necessarily want to play a game that is combined with other people, then they can play individually if they wanted to. So I got some games like that, and then I also got Frisbee, so they can, you know, little cheap stuff that can be fun. And if I can always have it later and use it for at home or whatever. So got that stuff. What else did I get? Oh, got some things for my office. Dividers to go in the drawers to kind of just keep my drawers a little bit neater with my lipsticks and my eyeliners and all that kind of stuff, because I need to clean out my makeup drawer and all that kind of stuff. So I just picked up like little containers like that. I can't remember what else, but I left out of there and had spent $50-something. That's ridiculous. I never spent that much in Dollar Tree. So, yeah, learned my lesson. I'm not going back in there. But I did get to the bank, got to Dollar Tree. Didn't get to the post office. I did want to do that as well. Not a necessity today. Just was going to do it since I was out, but since I don't have enough time because my husband's waiting on me, I'm just going to go ahead and meet up with him. We have not had lunch yet. It is late in the day. So we're going to get lunch, and then we're going to go to BJ's and pick up some salad stuff because I need to take a salad to the family reunion as well. So I want to get all my salad fixings from BJ's. Hopefully they have everything I need, and hopefully it's cheaper. Trying to get big bags, you know, of lettuce versus going to the store and getting the smaller ones and having to get multiples of them. So we'll see. I've never been to BJ, so I don't even know if they have that. I'm assuming they do, because I could get that like at Costco or Sam's Club. So I'm assuming BJ's has it as well. So we'll see. It'd be my first time in BJ's. Avery goes all the time, but I haven't actually been inside there yet. So I'll be able to go in and look around and see what it's like. So yeah. I should not have come this way, because this traffic is horrible trying to turn left out of here. But anyway, guys, let me catch up with him. I'll talk to you later.
I am stuck in the middle. Yeah, I'm stuck in between. I'm stuck in the position. Machine, so you're stuck in the middle, huh? I guess we're stuck in between. Life is a riddle, yeah, and I don't know what it means, nah. This is what it feels like. But you're not alone, 'cause I'm just like you.
BJ's. This is my first time in here, so I'm gonna make this quick, try to anyway, and I'll show y'all. It looks just like Sam's Club, so I'll turn y'all around. They're high. Ooh, look at this. I'm gonna go sleep in this. Look at this.
Once in the air, you realize what you want, the things that you dream of.
And my husband is over there trying out all the samples.
Mashed potatoes, some kind of mashed potatoes.
For this family reunion, and we are tired and hungry, aren't we, honey?
Yeah, we're tired and hungry.
Watch that car, honey. All right. We out of here. Say it again.
She's carrying the receipt, and I'm pushing the cart.
I told him I'd carry the receipt. Oh, man.
Okay.
Cousins.
Apparently, we holding up dinner. They waiting.
Okay. Hey, Bigo.
We got here right in time.
Right on time.
Where's
Warren?
Right on time. Okay, because I know I saw him, and he said he was coming.
Huh? Yeah, about
20
minutes.
20 minutes out? Okay. Isn't it funny? There she is. Y'all been wondering about her. They waiting for us to do the donut thing. We ain't done that. She too busy.
I'm gonna tell y'all this, nigga. I know I talk a lot, but I'm gonna keep this real quick.
See if they can hear you.
I've been waiting on her to get with me to do the.
That was good. Trip. That was good. That was good. I'm talking to myself now. Yeah, she a trip. That was good. But no, I've been waiting on her. So we're going to do it because they've been waiting.
I think my head always knew it, but I didn't tell my heart. Let go, I couldn't do it without falling apart. So give me something now. Give me a fix, tell me.
Got a space game going over here. Okay, sorry guys, once again I have not been really getting any footage of July, but here I'm going to get some. Me, Avery, and I are going to my little cousin's birthday party. Got our card, so it's at a swim club, so I'll show you a little bit of that. Don't know how much I'll get, but I'll try to get a little bit. So hold on. Can I get you on? This is the birthday girl. Look at her dress.
Pour la saison, aldrig borde vara problem.